And don't forget number 24 today.
What?
I said don't forget number 24 today. You're going to run your ear with them things on all time, you know.
He's busy for a Wednesday, isn't he? I think it was Christmas.
Newsnight has visited the small town of Grangetown, sandwiched between ICI's Wilton Works and the British steel plant at Blackerby. Some 20,000 jobs have been shed around the town in the past 2 decades. Mark Easton reports from a town where some inhabitants feel it's time to redraw an equation they think pits jobs against the quality of life.
This is Balco Road in Grangetown, enjoying unobstructed views of both the steel plant and the chemical works.
As I headed down the hill, I met Phyllis and Ida at the bus stop. Neighbours in Grangetown for over 40 years, but they told me no more.
Yeah, we wanted to stay, but we couldn't. We weren't allowed to. We had to go out. We had to move out.
You wanted to stay in those houses?
Yeah, we all wanted to.
We were all settled.
So why did you have to move out?
God knows.
Well, we had no other choice.
Turning the corner into 21st century Grangetown, I could barely believe what I saw. These homes were the heart of Grangetown. The Victorian terraces built for the families of men who beat the ore from nearby Eston Hills into the iron foundations of the industrial age. But like them, the inhabitants have left. The streets are abandoned. The desecrated shells await the demolition man.
People don't stand and talk at the bus stop anymore. They don't meet in the local shop.
I wanted to see Roy's hometown, to get a feel for the place that formed his view of the world. And so, we're on a day trip to Grangetown. Grangetown sits in the shadow of every type of industrial plant going. A port, a chemicals works, a power station and steel mills.
Like many industrial towns, it's a mixture of old and new. Older terraced houses and newer spacious estates. Proud of our past and confident in our future, we are generally considered a lively, friendly people.
Calm, say to yourself, at home. Calm, say to yourself, one of the family. We've taken to you so strong. It's clear we're going to get along.
Through the hard work and life of its early years, a strong sense of community was forged among the people.
This one, I think.
Looks like we may be here for the duration, sir.
Yes.
Sort this. Anyone fancy a pint? Yes, go on, then.
It's a garden centre. It's much, much more than that.
What? Pets, wicker s***, fragrant candles.
Oh, God, wait, everybody else.
Mom!
That was a public information film.
Well, with the time rapidly approaching 12 minutes past midnight, that's where we come to the end of Wednesday evening's programmes. On behalf of all of my colleagues, good night.
When you're brought up on it, it's like if you're brought up on beans on toast. You'll always like beans on toast, won't you?
Now you try and tell the young people of today that. I won't believe you.
Here is the news, and this is John Snaig reading it. A service that links the world by radio.
I suppose you think I'm going to talk rubbish. Well, quite right, I am.
They are watching that.
Here as well, and that's, although there's nobody in the park at the moment, it is heavily used.
Announced on the 17th of December 1973, went on through the coldest weeks of the winter.
We are limiting the use of electricity by almost all factories, shops, and offices to 3 days a week.
You'll turn shifts to memory for the 8 streets of all Gunnelas. Then built a few fancy new workshops, but the rest of it's gone back to grass. So my old Grangetown's dead, but the steelworks that gave it birth. But the new Grangetown is still the same. It's broke the salt of the air.
All the shops were in one street, Whitworth Road. And they obliged people lived from day to day with their groceries. And not shopping for a week as we do. They would, and the shops did sell them a penneth of tea or an ounce of sugar.
And now a look at programmes later this evening on BBC One.
There was a
a family atmosphere, and the people helped each other out in the streets. There was a lot of, all the front and back doors were open, and people ran in and out of the houses, and the children played happily together in the street.
When you began this tour, were there any other buildings?
Five. There were some farm buildings and a number of cottages, including those at Branch End, Eston Junction.
You commenced building about when?
We began on 1st of April 1881. From Bessemer Street to Balcourt Road, there will be 800 houses to accommodate between 5,000 and 6,000 people. This makes the town one of the largest undertakings in England.
I get the feeling someone made this morning just for me.
If any of our readers would like to know anything further, we would advise them to visit this wonderful place for themselves.